Morning, this is Daniel Weber, and you're listening to Heaven Bound.
I see a sea. I see my home. I see my blessed King there on his throne.
Good morning again, friends, and welcome one more time to Heaven Bound. On behalf of the good folks here at Calvary Bible Church, I am Doug Benedict, and along with Pastor Jim Jenkins, we are so excited that you are joining us once again for another episode of Heaven Bound. And we do hope you had a great Thanksgiving. We hope you didn't eat too much, and we hope that you can get out and exercise in this awesome snow that we've already gotten, and there's going to be more to come. With Thanksgiving coming to an end, it pretty much puts Christmas season into full high-speed gear, and that will be here in less than a month. Can you believe it? Christmas Sunday will be here in less than a month. It's just right around the corner. And we hope you're making plans to come join us today. I know a lot of people, only time they cross the threshold of a church will be Christmas Sunday. And we do hope that if you are looking for a good Bible-believing church, that the threshold that you will cross will be here at Calvary Bible Church. That Sunday, we will have a traditional service in the morning, and we'll even have a candlelight service that night. We'll give you some more details as that comes along, but right now let's focus on today. With today being the fourth Sunday of the month, we'll begin our services this morning at 9 o'clock with our fellowship breakfast, followed immediately after at 9:30 with Sunday school. Then at 10:30, we will have our morning service, and we'll be out of here by noon. Then 6 o'clock tonight, we'll have our evening service. And we'll break for half a week, and we'll be back here Wednesday night at 7 o'clock for our midweek prayer group and Bible study sessions. I know we talk about this a lot and how much church that seems like it actually is, but if you sit and think about how much time you spend outside of church, it's just a real small sliver. So plan on joining us. It's a breath of fresh air. Gets you away from everything in the world that's going on. You can come spend some great fellowship here. We're just like a family, and we would love to bring you in and be part of this family as well. If you want to come join us, our address is 6968 Sweeney Road, Gregg, New York. You can put that into a GPS and it'll get you just about here, but you will have to pay a little bit of attention as you get closer, because when you get on Sweeney Road, it might take you right past. So you can also take these super easy directions. If you're coming out of Boonville, head north on Route 12 and make a right-hand turn onto Burdick's Crossing Road. If you're coming out of Lowellville, head south on Route 12 and you're going to make a left-hand turn onto Burdick's Crossing Road. If you're coming out of West Lydon, head north on 26, keep straight onto 12D, head north on Route 12 and make a right-hand turn on to Burdick's Crossing Road. Now, Burdick's Crossing Road is located right by the Valley Brook Drive-In Movie Theater. So make sure you look for that, and the road will be right there. We're kind of down in a dip. And there are some small blue signs out on Route 12 that even point in which direction you need to go. So take Burdick's Crossing Road all the way to the end. You're going to make a left-hand turn onto Gregg Road, head up the hill, and make your first right-hand turn onto Sweeney Road. And we'll be up there about 200 yards on the right-hand side. Now, if you need a ride, for whatever reason, you can't get yourself here, why don't you call us this morning? Our phone number is 315-348-6271. You can also send an email to cbclewiscounty@gmail.com. And we'll do our best to line someone up to come pick you up. There's probably someone right around the corner from you that would just love to come give you a ride so you could join in the services here and the time of fellowship and learning from God's Word here at Calvary Bible Church. But now, if all else fails, we do stream all of our services live at cbclewiscounty.com as well as on livestream.com. But don't use that as an excuse, because there's just so much that you miss by not actually being here. So you can go on, check us out. There's some great resources on there, but plan on joining us. It doesn't matter what you drive or how you get here. There's plenty of room for everyone, and we do hope to see you here this morning. But now, as we gave you lots of directions on how to get here, let's talk about a city that we have an open invitation to. And John in Revelation talked about seeing this city coming down from heaven. So if you have your Bibles, turn to Revelation chapter 21, and we're going to begin in verse 1. And as you're turning, let's listen to the Gaither Vocal Band as they sing, "I'll Meet You in the Morning."
I will meet you in the morning by the bright riverside, when all sorrows have drifted away. I'll be standing at the portals when the gates open wide, at the close of life's long dreary day.
Was the Gaithers, and "I'll Meet You in the Morning" by the bright riverside when all sorrow has drifted away. I'll be standing at the portals when the gate open wide, at the end of life's long, dreary day. And the last line is, "In that city that is built four square." Say, preacher, what exactly does that mean? In the book of Revelation, we find that toward the end of the book, it gives us a description of the New Jerusalem. We would call it heaven. I saw the New Jerusalem descending out of heaven. We would call that heaven now, the New Jerusalem, but one day the New Jerusalem is going to descend to this, and it's unclear whether it will descend to the earth or hover right above the earth. But at that point, it's going to matter anyway, because we're going to have access to heaven. You say, well, we have to take a jet? No. Well, we need a backpack? No. We'll be able to have access to the New Jerusalem. I'm not really sure. If you think it's going to come and hover above the earth, fine. If you think it's going to descend and actually reside here on the earth, fine. Either way, I'm good with it. It's not going to matter really one way or another. But the Bible describes this place. It says that it looked like a bride adorned for her husband coming down from God out of heaven as a bride adorned for her husband. Most of the time we say this, and I say it somewhat jokingly, I've never seen a bride that wasn't looking like a bride. I've seen some guys that could have used some alteration, but the bride is usually pretty good, dressed up, good looking. I've had brides in gowns, and I've had their grooms in sneakers, but usually the bride is dressed up. And if you go to a wedding, most of the time, that's what we would say, that the bride is all dressed up. And John said, I saw the New Jerusalem descending from God out of heaven, adorned as a bride adorned for her husband. Now, which indicates to us that the New Jerusalem is going to be a place of exquisite beauty. It is going to be a beautiful place. And John describes it in somewhat detail. And, you know, the streets are made of gold. Say, is that true, preacher? Are the streets made of gold? Yes, they are. The city itself is pure gold. Are there really pearly gates? Yes, there are. There are pearly gates. There are three gates on the city is four-sided, and there are three gates on every side of the city, and every gate is a pearl. And from the reading, it would appear that the three pearls are surrounded by one giant pearl on these cities. Now, so it is a city of pure gold. The streets are gold. It is a place where Jesus said in John chapter 14, in my Father's house are many mansions. It is a place of mansions. Now, someone will ask, well, will we need mansions in heaven? How do I know? I've never been there yet. But the Bible says it is a place of mansions. It is a place of great beauty. It is a place that is quite large. We heard that song, it is the city that is built four square. Now, how exactly the New Jerusalem is laid off in detail, it is not clear. Now, the Bible does say this, that the wall that surrounds the New Jerusalem is 200 plus feet high. It is very high. It is a very high wall. And it has these gates of pearl. Now, the Bible tells us that he measured the wall, and it was 144 cubits. So if a cubit is 18 inches, then we know that 144 feet plus another half of that would give us approximately 216 feet is how high that wall is. And it says, and the city lieth four square. You say, well, what does that mean? Well, let's read a little bit. And the length is as large as the breadth. And he measured the city with the reed 12,000 furlongs. The length and the breadth and the height of it are equal. And so 12,000 furlongs, a furlong is about 1/8 of a mile. So if you divide 8 into 12,000. You're going to come up with, I forget what it is offhand, but approximately, they figure it to be about 1,500 miles. We'll say this, about 1,500 miles square. Not exactly, but about 1,500 miles at the base. 1,500 miles wide, 1,500 miles long. That's how wide the city is. It is a city that is four square. But now notice this. It is not only 1,500 miles on the base, on all four sides, but it is also 1,500 miles high. Now, here is our dilemma. It says that the breadth and the length and the height of it are equal. Now, I have no doubt about that. I'm not, that doesn't concern me. If heaven is a cube, if it is a cube, then it's a 1,500 mile, as the song said, is the city that lieth four square. It is a 1,500 mile cube. The height and the breadth and the width of it are equal. But the Bible does not really say that it is a cube. Now, we have thought that, but I'm not sure that the city itself is not in the shape of a pyramid. Nobody knows for sure, but it is either in that shape of a pyramid or is in the shape of a cube. I have a tendency to think that it may be a pyramid. Now, I won't be dogmatic about that and say for sure and say, well, if you think it's a cube, you're wrong. But I think that it may be designed as a cube, as a pyramid. I'm sorry. If you look up on the internet, and I know you can read anything on the internet, you can find anything on the internet. But if you look on there and type in Enoch, E-N-O-C-H, and the Great Pyramid, you will find that the Egyptians claim that Enoch built the Great Pyramid, that he built it. Now, if Enoch did build it, where did he get the design? Where did he get the design? And that thing is laid off just exquisitely. And the dimensions of it are really, when you look at it, are just astronomical about how it is laid off. But if Enoch did build it, and I'm not going to say, well, if you think he didn't build it, you're wrong. But if he did, and tradition says the Egyptians say that he did build it, that where did he get that design? So heaven may be in the shape of a pyramid. You remember Enoch only lived 365 years and God took him to heaven to be with him. So the city lieth four square. Now, if it is in the shape of a cube, heaven is 93 million cubic miles. Is heaven going to be big enough for everybody, preacher? It is a city that, if you worked it out, and we have several math teachers in our congregation, and they are brilliant. Oh, they are brilliant. Our math teachers are brilliant. If you meet B.J. Bailey or if you meet Bob Bosco, I'm telling you, they are brilliant. And I believe it was Bob that told me, he figured it out, that the city is either 9.3 million cubic miles or 93 million cubic miles, no matter how you look at it. It is a tremendously big place, and it is going to be a place of exquisite beauty. The wall around it is 216 feet, gates of pearl, streets of gold. It describes the inhabitants there. No one will ever die. No one will ever be sorry. You know, one of the verses to that song said this, I will meet you in the morning by the bright riverside. Is there a river, preacher? Yes, there is. The river of life proceeds from the throne of God. I will meet you in the morning by the bright riverside when all sorrow has faded away. Boy, don't we live in a world of sorrow. The last line of that verse says, I'll meet you at the close of life's long, dreary day. Even though there are some really good things about this life, and there are, there's lots of happiness, and there are lots of things in this life that we rejoice over and are thankful for. We are. But in the end, there's so much dreariness, so many people. Everybody we know dies. Oh, how sad is that? People get sick, people have heart attacks, people get cancer. Little children die, old people die. At the end of life's long, dreary day. Oh, but the Bible tells us this, that there'll be no more death there. Nobody will ever die in that beautiful city that lieth four square. But may I ask you this question, dear friend? As beautiful as heaven is, and it is beautiful, the one thing, and let me say this, the one thing that will make heaven heaven is that Jesus will be there. If heaven were nothing more than tar paper shacks and the streets were concrete and black asphalt, it would still be heaven because Jesus would be there. When I get there, I'm going to meet Mom and Dad. I've had two of my brothers have passed on and over to the other side. Stonewall Jackson, when he died, said this, "Let us pass over the river and rest in the shade of the tree." Oh, friend, we're going to pass over. I'm going to pass over to the other side. Jesus said to the disciples when they got in the boat on the Sea of Galilee, "Let us pass over to the other side." Friend, one day we're going to pass over to the other side. I'm going to pass over to the other side. The song says, "I'll meet you in the morning by the bright riverside when all sorrow has drifted away." May I ask this question to you? Will I meet you there? Will I meet you in the shade of the tree? After we get to heaven, after we meet Jesus, I'm going to be looking for my family. I'm going to be looking for my friends who have already passed over to the other side. One of the dearest friends I had in this life was Francis Rocker. If you live down Port Lydon way, you may have known Francis. What a guy he was. He passed over to the other side. His nephew, it's hard to believe his nephew is the same age as he is. If you meet Pete Fitzgerald over there in Port Lydon, Francis Rocker was his uncle. And one night, Pastor Penrod from the old Congregational Church went over to Pete's house, and France and Pete sat on the street corner till about 10 o'clock at night over there in front of the hardware, Mannequin's Hardware. You remember that over there in Port Lydon? They sat over there till about 10 o'clock, and Pete said, "I believe that preacher will be gone now." And they drove over to Shaver Road where Pete lives, and man, that old preacher was sitting there in the driveway. Pete said to Francis, "I don't care what happens, I'm not getting saved tonight." About half hour later, Pete was on his knees asking Jesus to save him. Francis did not get saved that night, but several weeks later, he couldn't take it anymore. He had called the preacher up at 3 o'clock in the morning and said, "You come talk to me about getting saved." My friend Francis Rocker has passed over to the other side. My family, my mom and dad, my brothers, they passed over to the other side. My uncle, my great-grandmother, my grandmother, they have all passed over to the other side. One of my great-great-grandmothers, written on her tombstone, "For by grace are you saved," written on her tombstone. Oh, I look forward to seeing them one day. Friend, may I ask you this question? Will I meet you there? Song we sing in church, "Meet me there, meet me there." Will you meet me there? Where the tree of life is blooming, meet me there. When the storms of life are o'er, on that happy, blissful shore, where the faithful part no more, meet me there. I sometimes play the piano and sing in church, and there's a song that I love. "After you've been there, 10,000 years, a million, maybe two. Look for me, for I will be there too. How about you, friend? Will you be there? The alternative to heaven is not a nice thing to think about. It is not a nice place to go. I said last Sunday, I don't understand why people will give up a place where you never die, where you never get sick, where you never say goodbye. Why people would not want to go there. I can't tell you how many people, and I mean this, who will look right at you and say, I'm not interested. Not interested. Not interested. Not interested in living forever. Not interested in never dying. How can you not be interested in it? But I'm telling you, people say that to me all the time. Friend, may I ask you again, will you meet me there? There's no disappointment in heaven, no weariness, sorrow, or pain, no hearts that are bleeding and broken, no song with a silent refrain. Never grow old, never grow old, in a land where we'll never grow old. Wouldn't you like to go to a place like that? Wouldn't you like to go to a place like that? Jesus loves you. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that our Father in heaven tells of his love in a book he has given. Wonderful things in the Bible I see. Oh, but the dearest is that Jesus loves me. Friend, he loves you. He died on the cross and paid for your sins. And if you'll just ask him, come into your heart to forgive you of your sin, of unbelief, of not trusting him, and asking him to come into your heart and save you, to forgive you of your sin. There's never been a person that he has turned away. Never. Friend, would you ask him today? Would you call upon him today to be your Savior today? Would you trust him today, right now? Look, you say, well, I'm driving down the road. That's all right. Where the heart man believeth, if you look, God sees your heart. And where the mouth confession is made, all you got to do, driving down the road, in the kitchen, out the barn, on the tractor, somewhere. If you just call upon him, Lord, I know that I'm a sinner, but I believe that you love me, and I believe that you died for me. And the best way I know how, I trust you. I trust you, Lord. Come into my heart and save me. Come into my heart and save me. Lord, take me to that place. Lord, I want to spend eternity. I don't want to die and go to hell. Lord, I want to live forever with you. Lord, come into my heart and save me right now. Friend, if you'll ask him, he'll save you. And if you ask him, would you contact us? Calvary Bible Church, Greg, New York. We'd love to hear from you. But dear friend, trust him today. Call upon him today. Because I'm telling you this, tomorrow just might be too late.
Friend, did you just ask Jesus to save you today? Or do you have any more questions about how you can know for sure that you're going to heaven when you die? Maybe you were like Francis Rocker and you've been putting this off and putting it off, and now today you want to confirm and reserve your home in heaven. Give us a call this morning. Our phone number here is 315-348-6271. Or you can even send an email to cbclewiscounty@gmail.com. And we would just love to talk with you. We'd love to pray with you. We would love to help you in any way we possibly can. And another thing you could do, why don't you just come this morning? Get it all settled today. In fact, we have a place in a pew that can only be filled by you. Thank you again for joining us this half hour. Lord willing, we will catch you again next week on Heaven Bound.